In the previous video, we covered reports based on different components of the data, including fixations, saccades, samples, and interest areas. In this video, we'll cover how to create a binned time course report, which is particularly useful for visual world studies, but can also be used for other types of experiments as well. The time course binning analysis option, which can be accessed from the Analysis Reports menu, creates an output file in which each row corresponds to a particular duration or bin of time. These reports are most often used to get information about the percent of time that was spent on each of several interest areas as the trials of the experiment progressed. When you create a time course report, you should first specify the duration of each of the bins. The default is 20 milliseconds, which means that each row in the output file will correspond to a 20 millisecond period of time. Then you can choose the variables that you'd like to include. These will make up the columns of the report. As with the other reports, when you select a variable, you can see its definition below. And you can use this arrow to move it into the Selected Variables box to include it in the report. And as with other reports, you can use the up-down arrows to change the left-right ordering of the variables in the output file. You'll notice some variables have asterisks in the label. If you include one of these variables, then it will create one column for each interest area and another column to represent any areas not covered by any interest areas. For example, if you ran a visual world experiment that had four interest areas on each trial, and you include the variable average IA asterisk sample count percent, then it will create five columns, one for each of your four interest areas, and one to represent non-interest area regions. The asterisk in the variable name will be replaced by the interest area index for the columns that will be created for each of your interest areas, and by a zero for the non-interest area region. So, you can easily get percent of time spent on each interest area for each bin from this report. Note, as you'll notice by the variable labels, some variables in the report are based on averaged data across the two eyes, and other variables are based on left or right eye data only. There are some additional filtering options in this report creation dialog that are worth consideration. There's an option for the maximum number of bins to include, which can be useful when your trials could vary in duration and you want to make sure that the data doesn't extend too long for trials which might be outliers. Also, the report dialog by default is based on there being four interest areas on each trial, but you can specify different numbers of interest areas and/or indices and labels here. The time course analysis is based on sample data, and there are some options that allow you to select which samples are allowed to contribute to the report. You can filter based on eye position in this top section, and based on whether the eye is in fixation or saccade in the section below. Also, if you'd like your report to be based on averaged data across all trials in a group or condition, then you can choose to create a separate report that presents averaged data across all trials in the group based on the current grouping configuration in the inspector. If you'd like to use this option, then it's important to make sure that you have set up the grouping properly under Edit Trial Grouping. For example, if you have a variable that identifies the level of an independent variable for each trial in your viewing session, and your data is grouped by that variable, then the separate collapsed report will give you the averaged data for all the trials in each group. Here, I've grouped the data by a variable called condition, so when I run the report, it will create a second report with data averaged across all trials for each value of that condition variable. Let's run it and take a quick look at the resulting data file in Excel. We can see that the output file has a separate row for each bin of time, and the variables that we selected are represented as columns in the file. Including the variables with an asterisk in the label resulted in separate columns for each interest area, and another for areas not covered by any interest area. We can also open the collapsed report that was created and see that the data has been averaged for all trials in the group for each of the groups. You can read more about the time course report options and access a listing of the variable definitions in the Data Viewer User Manual under the section Data Analysis and Output, Time Course Binning Analysis.